Hello friends, I am Chetan Shorde. Today training topic on cleaning validation. Definition of cleaning. Cleaning is the process of removing unwanted substances such as a dirt, infectious agent and other impurities from an object or environment. Important parameter on cleaning process. One is the cleaning agent, concentration of cleaning agent, contact time, temperature and pressure. As for industrial practices, cleaning equipment categorized on three different parts for validation. One is the direct product contact surfaces, second is indirect product contact surfaces, and third is the non-product contact surfaces. Today training topic cover on only cleaning product contact surfaces. A surface which may directly contact manufacturing product for which there is generally a reasonable expectation of transfer of residue of the product. For example, direct product contact surfaces, equipment in parental dosage form, manufacturing vessel, sampler, stirrer, filtration vessel and filling accessories like manifold, pump, piston, syringe, etc. And oral dosage form, milling, shifter, RMG, FBD, octagonal blender, compression machine, coating machine and packing machine. Definition of the cleaning validation. Cleaning process adequately and consistently remove product. A residue process, residue and environmental contaminant from the manufacturing equipment system so that this equipment system can be safely used for the manufacturing of specified subsequent products. Second topic is the sampling. Sampling to evaluate the cleaning effectiveness, it is necessary to sample the of the equipment to establish the level of residue present. Sampling we can done on two ways. One is the swab sampling, second is the rinse sampling. Swab sampling. Swab sample shall be considered as a primary criteria for cleaning validation. Firstly, how to identify the swab location of particular equipment? Based on the hard to clean area, hard to reach area, hard to sanitize area, based on these things, we can identify the sampling location of particular equipment. Then we can swab with the help of the template and swab sticks. Template sizes are 2 by 2 inch. We can increase this if surface area for accessible. Then swab stick. Template made by the stainless steel and Teflon. And swab sticks made by the fibrous material. With the help of swab stick we can sample. Do the swabbing in the fenton motion across the surface. First apply. The swab is a vertical direction and rotate 90 degrees Celsius. Now horizontal the position of the swab. Show figure. Figure is there. Firstly the 2 by 2 inch is a template. Then with the help of swab stick we can swab vertically. Then rotate the swab in 90 degrees Celsius. Then move horizontally. Second sampling process is a rinse sample. Rinse sample we can do when swab equipment part there is not accessible for swab sampling. Or that time we are going for the rinse sampling. Otherwise, we can rinse sample take additionally. Rinse sample we can do two way. One type is a rinse sampling technique is the take a grab sample from the final portion of the rinse solvent during the final rinse of the cleaning process. In that process, during the end of the cleaning process, final rinse we can withdraw for the sampling and send the QC. And second type is a rinse sampling to utilize the separate sampling rinse after completion of the cleaning process. And second type, after completion of the cleaning process, we can take the additional final rinse water, purified water or WFI, where sufficient take a sufficient quantity of water for wet the all part of equipment. And then we are collect the sample and send the QC for any hazardous for the patients.